So in this video, we're going to create another table and we're going to use the sheet 2 information here. So it gives us the product ID, which is the same product ID that we've previously been using in the transactions, and the name and, where applicable, the color. So let's create a new table. Hopefully you know how to do this before I even mention it. And you know what to do now. So we have to type in the column names. Now, just one word of warning. I generally avoid having a column name called name. I find it not that useful, especially when we're going to be looking at multiple tables. For instance, we've got a transaction, we might have a product, we might have a customer name, then we might have a location name. There's probably lots of different names. So if you're using SQL Server, I would say don't call something just name. Have it a bit more of a descriptive name. Now, what is the data types? Well, these are integers, just like our previous version. Now, these are text, so I use varchars for this. It's a bit of a complicated subject why I use varchars. And the number that's in the bracket tells me the longest number of characters I'm allowed. So I'm going to have 50 characters, which is enough for what I want. So I'm going to change that for color as well. So I'm now going to save this as a product table. Notice it doesn't appear in the Object Explorer. I need to refresh. So let's populate it. So I'll select everything and I paste. And it's just 504 rows. It will be done very quickly. Hopefully you're as a dab hand at this, you know exactly how to do all of this. So what I want now to have is the product name. So I can go select star from dbo.product. Oh, there's a squiggly underline. Why is this? Well, it's a bit like the refresh. Every time we add a new table, query, procedure, the autocomplete, the IntelliSense over here, doesn't realize that it's been added. And what we need to do is refresh the IntelliSense. And we do that by going to Edit, IntelliSense, Refresh Local Cache. In reality, I just press Control and Shift and R, but this is the way to actually find this refresh. And in a few seconds, this squiggly red line disappears. Right, so now let's execute. And we can see we've got two different results here. We've got the transactions table and we've got the product. Now, what I want is to have the product name up here in the transactions table. And I do this as part of the from clause. Now, this is probably the most complicated part of this particular course. What I need to do is create a join. So let's just map it out in terms of what we've got. We've got a table, transactions table, which includes the columns, purchase order, ID, order quantity, product ID, unit price, and line total. And we've got this product table with product ID, product name, and color. And what we're saying is, I would like in this table here, I want an extra column of product name. I want this to go essentially here. So we need a way to link from one table to the other. Now, to do this, what we need to have is a field which is the same in both tables. And you can see that the field which is the same is product ID. So there is my join. Any rows in table transaction and any rows on product ID, on the table product, where the product ID is the same, where they are equal, that is where my connection should be. So how do we write this? So select star from dbo.transactions, join dbo.product. So there is this arrow, there's your join. But what do we join it on? We join it on the transactions field. So where the transactions product ID is equal to the product ID. So let's execute that, see what happens. And now you can see we have got just one result table, 8,845 rows. And we have our first table here when we're using select star. So here's the five columns from table transactions and the three columns from table product. Now, of course, this is a bit unwieldy. We can simplify this by using the word as. So I want, instead of dbo.transactions, I want to just call it as T. And instead of dbo product, I just want it to be called P. So now we are joining T, or we have the table T, and we're joining table P on T.productID equals P.productID. And you'll often see tables being represented by just one or two characters in SQL Server code. So just as we use the as in the select clause to rename our columns, we can also use it in the from clause to rename our tables. Now, just one word of warning, and this is where it might get a bit complicated. This only works where every single one of these product IDs in table transaction has got an equivalent in the table product. If there was one that didn't, say I had this as product ID 10,000, then it wouldn't, this row would not get returned because there would be no equivalent of a product 10,000 here in here. So if I wanted to guarantee that every single row of my transaction table would be returned, plus any additional data in the table product, then instead of using the word join, I would use left join. So it goes from my first table, all of the rows guaranteed, and any additional data in table product. In this particular example, we have the totality of data already, so we don't need that. So what I might do now is just reduce the number of columns that I'm seeing. So I want purchase order ID, order quantity, product ID, unit price, line number, so line total, and the product name. I don't need to have product ID twice. I could add in the color as well, maybe. Okay, so I'll execute that. And ambiguous column name. So what's that talking about? Well, it's because we have a product ID in the table transactions and a product ID in the table product. And even though we know that they're equal, the computer wants you to specify which one we're talking about. Well, I want the one in the table transactions. The table transactions we've now redefined as table T. T. So I'll just need to put T dot at the beginning. That's all it needs. And you only need to do that where there's an ambiguous column names, an ambiguity. You can put it in even when there isn't, if you think that will make things clearer. So now if I execute, we now have the five columns from table transactions and two additional columns from table product. So these joins, as I say, probably the most complicated part of this particular course. Don't worry if you haven't quite got it. We'll be progressing onto other clauses, and that's all you need to know about this join. So in this video, we have completed our look at the from clause. And next, well, we've got 8,845 rows. Is there a way of reducing that? Say I wanted to search for a particular set of rows. Well, we can do that in the next video.